If you're looking for something to watch while spring cleaning, if you need motivation to tackle a big project, or if you are in the market for tons and tons of kitchen organizing tips, you have come to the right place. After 4 years of living in our house, we moved in with a newborn and just put things wherever they could go. We've done little organizing projects here and there, but we've never completely overhauled the kitchen until now. And I am here after weeks of researching, planning, shopping, and organizing to give you the final product and show you all of the really easy, simple, affordable solutions that I have used all over our kitchen that you can use as well. My husband is a chef and I am a childcare provider in my home to up to 10 kids. So we are cooking in this kitchen for every single meal, every single day. So we owe it to ourselves to have a kitchen that is functional and looks good in the process, but we didn't want to break the bank and you don't have to either. So this is going to be a lot of tips, so get ready. Before I even started researching or shopping, I went through and I sketched our entire kitchen. I am no artist, but I sketched all the cabinets and then I started thinking of where things would make the most sense going. And so I started writing it out and then I moved on to the research phase. So after that, I started researching on other videos, looking on Amazon, Dollar Tree, just looking through my house, seeing what we had, and then I started really thinking of what would make the most sense with our kitchen. And I bought most of the stuff on Amazon and the Dollar Tree, with some things at Walmart and Target, and then just things we had around the house as well. When it was time to get to work, I actually spent a nap time on a Friday and then pretty much the most of the day on Saturday, from morning to late afternoon, working on cleaning everything out and getting to work. So the very first step, I wanted to make sure I didn't just take stuff out and put it back. I really wanted the cabinets to be deep cleaned. It is springtime, so this is a perfect time to do it. I just used my vinegar water solution that I use for all-purpose cleaning every day to clean the inside of the cabinets. But when it came to the outside of the cabinets, we have these beautiful cherry wood cabinets and I really wanted to take good care of them. And so I use this wonderful wood conditioning and cleaning product. It cleans and conditions in one step and it really made our cabinets just like buttery, shiny, and just rich in color, and I really loved it. And I actually got a little bit emotional while cleaning them. I'm getting a little emotional cleaning this kitchen. I'm like turning into Marie Kondo or something, but I'm just getting really emotional thinking about how much time our family spends in this room and how grateful I am to have this space. And even though it doesn't look exactly like I want it to, it functions so well for our family and it's blessed us in so many ways. Then when it was time to actually empty everything out, I sorted it all by category so that things that weren't grouped together that I want to group together were together when it came time to actually organize. So it was all over my house. I'd highly recommend doing this without children around because it's gonna be a while you're figuring out where everything can fit. One of the main problems with our kitchen was that things that we needed while we were at the stove weren't near the stove. Things that we needed when we were putting dishes away were all over the kitchen, so we were constantly running around. And so I really wanted to make sure with this reorganization that we put things close to where we actually use them. So our mixing bowls went from a locked cabinet away from the island to actually in the island. So when we're cooking, we can just grab them. Same thing goes for all of our measuring items, measuring cups, liquid measuring cups, and silicone baking liners. And then for our coffee, I made sure when we moved our coffee pot to a new location, I moved all of the coffee related items right above it so that it's right there when we need it. We also didn't have our Pyrex dishware and our platter and our baking sheets near the stove, so we made sure to move those to a prime location where our food storage containers used to be. It didn't make sense to have them there because we don't use them there, so we switched those as well to an area that we don't need to access as often because we're only using those once in a while. And then other things like cups next to the sink, mugs next to the coffee pot, you know, utensils and spices next to the stove, those are all very important that you have them in reach. Believe it or not, we did not have a junk drawer before this. I didn't like the idea of a junk drawer, and so all of our spices were in this really big drawer next to the stove, which seemed good in theory, but they got all mixed up. So we found a new home for those, and we used to drop papers on the counter right above that spice drawer. And so I decided to help curb our urge to put stuff on the counter, we would make a junk drawer right underneath in the same, it's the same width as the counter. And instead of putting the papers on the countertop, we would put them in the drawer. And so I just use really simple Dollar Tree containers to house things like cords, baby monitor, the Kindle, chargers, camera equipment for our channel, and just other miscellaneous items that we need close by that are often getting left on the countertop. Now they all have a home in a drawer, so they don't have to sit on the countertop anymore. Before, all of our big utensils for cooking were just in these two drawers, totally haphazardly. They constantly were getting in the way. We couldn't get the drawers shut and open all the time, and it was hard to find what we needed. So we just purchased these really simple spring-loaded pressurized bamboo dividers. I got four of them, two for each drawer, and so we were able to really separate everything by type. So now we know exactly where everything is. It has a spot to go back. It looks nice. Nothing is shifting around. And then our nicer wooden and metal utensils, we put in a crock on the counter. And so that way it looks nice. And that way we don't have to have everything in the drawers. A lot of people wouldn't need as many serving utensils and cooking utensils, but we like to cook a lot of different things at the same time. And so we didn't want to get rid of any. Something I was really excited to finally do was the famous Lazy Susan from the Dollar Tree, where you just take two cake pans and then you put some marble. These work really well. My husband and I are both pretty short. We're 5'3", 5'4". And so we put those on the middle shelf where it was almost out of reach, but we can still easily spin and grab what we need. Whereas we used to house all of our like cooking sprays and oils and things like that in tubs, and they were constantly just spilling and getting dirty, and they were falling on top of each other. So now it's really nice to have them up a level, and we can easily reach them for just $3 a piece. It's so awesome. Another thing I really like to do is use the shelf add-ons that you can buy at the Dollar Tree or Walmart or on Amazon that give you a lift to certain items but still allow you to use the rest of the shelf for taller items. So for example, in our coffee cabinet, we have a bunch of mugs that are about the half the size of our coffee accessories. So our milk frother and various other coffee related items, those are all pretty tall. And so we could fit all of our mugs on two tiers and then the rest of the items on just one level, but they all are on the same amount of shelf space, but we could use that like extended shelf to fit all of the mugs in the same amount of space. I searched high and low for the best spice solution for all of our spices. And so I was looking up so many different solutions, and I found that sometimes the simplest and easiest and most affordable solution is the best. So we just got these really simple, easy, affordable foam pads that run front to back in your drawer, and you just stack them next to each other. And they have little grooves in them to keep your spices from moving around, and they have been the perfect solution. We can fit all of them in a smaller amount of space, see exactly what we have, what we need. We're limited on the space, so we're not overbuying, and it just looks super nice and was cheap, and I love cheap. Another thing I love to do is to add shelves and drawers where they aren't already, but where you need them. So in the cabinet underneath our sink, it's a large, tall cabinet, but we have a lot of stuff that we need in it, and they're kind of taller items. So I bought some really inexpensive pull out wire drawers, and they are really great because I can fit so much more in the same amount of space, and I'm really using the vertical space. Also, when we moved into our house, one of our smaller cabinets only had one shelf. I don't know what happened to the others. And so instead of making our own shelves, I got a really good deal on a create a shelf. And so there's lots of different ways you can customize it, but this has been absolutely perfect for all of our plates, our bowls, our smaller plates, and all of the little things that you use for eating on a daily basis, little ramekins and things like that, because they all have smaller stacks, but I needed more of them. So this worked absolutely perfect, and then there was even some room on the side for our more special plates. I have struggled with kids' accessories and cups and bowls and all of that stuff for years, and I finally found a really good solution for our family. I've been in so many houses where you open up an upper cabinet and out spill like all the sippy cups, or a kid wants the Mickey one and the Mickey one's way in back, and so you have to like have them all fall out on you when you're getting hit in the face. And so we decided to use a drawer for these, because then the kids can get them in and out if they want. They're accessible. They all lay flat, nothing's falling out on us, and we're limited on space. Now, if you don't have a whole drawer to use, just consider putting them in bins. This is another tip that we love to do. We do this for our coffee. We put all of that in bins. It used to be in a drawer and they were shifting and just getting really messy everywhere. I also use it for my husband's drink accessories. So he does a lot of like his own pre-workout and supplements and stuff. So he has a whole bunch of bags and bottles. So I just put those in a bin so he can get it all down and then put it all back. I also use this for candles, essential oils, and the diffuser. And just whenever you can group things, it just makes your life simpler and you're not getting hit in the head, which is a win. While it is nice to have certain things on the counter, it is also nice to get things off the counter if they aren't adding a ton of functionality or aren't beautiful. So we decided to move our toaster off of the counter, even though I do use it every day, sometimes multiple times a day. It's just not pretty and it gets crumbs everywhere, and so it's nice to be able to clean the counters easily underneath. So we found a spot for it in a cabinet right above the outlet where we use it. And then other things like our sponge and our gloves when we're dishwashing, I didn't want to put them in a cabinet where, you know, they're not really airing out or they're dripping on other things, but I'm sick of them sitting on the countertop or on the edge of the sink. So I got this really easy, nice, sleek, simple human suction cup container that just sticks right to the side of your sink. And that way, you know, when you walk into the room, you're not seeing those things. I don't know about you guys, but whenever I'm on Instagram or watching other videos, I always wonder, where do they keep their water bottle? We always have a few water bottles just sitting in the kitchen that, you know, we don't wash them after every use. So I just tuck it right behind our coffee pot. So if you have a coffee pot or some taller item that you can kind of tuck those things behind, and that can be the place where you keep them. And I'm loving this tip. It just seems pretty obvious, but something that I never thought of before. One thing I really want to drill home to you guys is that you don't need fancy bins. You don't need container store expensive things. While those are nice, they're not necessary. There are so many things you can do with dollar store bins. Just the simple drawer organizers that come in 2 to 3 to a pack, depending on the sizes, can do so much. I redid our whole junk drawer, my new favorite drawer, which has all of our measuring cups and spoons and stuff like that in it. All of those use the Dollar Tree bins. I also use the bigger Dollar Tree bins all over our kitchen, all over our house, just to dump stuff in, and then they're corralled and contained. And they look nice enough. They don't have to be perfectly beautiful or ornate. You also can use older food storage containers. We used some in this project. I put some can koozies and little wine charms in an old Tupperware container because it was just the perfect size to fit up in our cabinet. When it comes to the finishing touches, instead of just disliking our kitchen or doing a huge remodel, I just decided to work with what we have. So because we have the wood tones and we have a lot of white in our house as well, I decided to play off of that in our kitchen. So one thing I really love to do is incorporate trays. So I love having our coffee pot on a tray, and sometimes we'll put our utensil crock on a tray. And I just love trays because you can easily clean underneath them. And what I really love is that it can take things that aren't very pretty and make them more unnoticeable. So for example, our Brita pitcher was always something we wanted out all the time. It just was kind of an eyesore. But by putting it on a tray next to our coffee pot and a cute little canister, you don't really notice it anymore. And I also love using things that kind of get things off of the counter. So I have this absolutely gorgeous thrifted pedestal cake stand with some really ornate detail. And instead of having it on a shelf in our dining room, I now have it right next to our sink with some pretty candles that I can light and a faux succulent. And I just think it's absolutely beautiful. And it's incorporating things that I love into space that I'm in all the time. And it's now a functional piece for us. I've never been a huge one for art in the kitchen, like on the counters, but now that we have the space, I added in one of my favorite little plaques that says, "Lunch is now being served," and it brings in the white. And I propped it up against a cutting board, which is another great idea, is to add functional pieces in, but make them beautiful and have them add to the art and the beauty of your space. But we also have a lot of other functional things that are also beautiful. This really cute tiered white fruit basket is really cute and it fits nicely in the corner and adds a pop of white. We brought in our white canisters with all of our different kinds of sugars and flowers into the kitchen to brighten it up more. And then our utensil holder is white and our coffee canister is white. And then I also put a little mug tree with little dainty white coffee cups next to the coffee pot as well. So it's bringing in those different textures and colors and wood tones, you know, make it work for your kitchen. But for ours, that worked really well because we have the dark and the light. The befores and afters of this project are simply amazing, and I'm so excited about how it all turned out. It only took about $200 of items to completely transform our kitchen and one whole day of work, but it's totally worth it now. I love being in here. My husband is figuring everything out now, and he is loving that everything is in a space that makes more sense. And the best part is now everything has a home, so our kitchen is now clutter-free on a daily basis. That brings so much happiness to my heart and to our day. Leave any of your easy and affordable kitchen organizing ideas in the corresponding community tab posts for this video. And I would absolutely love if you would subscribe if you like organizing, decluttering, working mom, daycare, and just relatable real life mom videos, because that's what we have here. Thank you guys for watching. Happy organizing!